Hello students, welcome to geography class. Today we are going to deal with chapter 2, major landforms of the earth. This chapter is divided into two parts. Today you will learn about first part, landforms, how landforms are formed, mountains, fold mountains, types of mountains, block mountains, volcanic mountains, and importance of mountain. Let's start with introduction. The earth has a solid surface made up of rocks and soil. It is called the crust. Out of the total area of this surface, about 71% is covered by water. The remaining 29% is above the surface of water in the form of land masses. The vast areas of water surrounding the land masses are interconnected, so the level of water remains the same everywhere. This level of water is called the sea level. The height or the depth of any point on the earth's surface is measured with a reference to this level. For example, Mount Everest, which is the highest point on the earth's surface, is 8,848 meters above the sea level. Now we are moving to landforms. The surface of the earth is not the same everywhere. Some parts are elevated higher than the surrounding area. Some are rugged and others are flat. In other words, the earth's surface has different types of landforms. Depending upon elevation and slope, land has been divided into three major types of landforms: mountains, plateaus, and plains. Now we are moving to next slide. How landforms are formed? Most landforms are formed by processes acting deep under the earth's surface. These processes are known as endogenous processes. Endogenous is internal process and it is happening within the earth. The solid surface layer of the earth is made up of a number of pieces that fit together like the pieces of a jigsaw. These pieces, called plates, float on molten rocks and move relative to each other. As they move, parts of the earth's surface are pushed up, pulled down, bent or broken to create new landforms. All landforms are shaped by exogenous process. Exogenous is external process. This happens outside the surface of the earth. For example, heat and cold make rocks crack and break. So do some actions of plants, animals, and people. Wind, water, and moving ice break up rocks too. They also carry away the broken pieces and deposit them elsewhere. Due to this exogenous and endogenous process, there can be some difference or formation of new landforms on the surface of the earth. Now we are moving to the next slide, major types of landform, that is mountains. We all are familiar with this topic, mountains. We have seen mountains, right? Yes. Let's see what are mountains. A mountain is a conical mass of land rising to much greater heights than the surrounding areas. Its pointed top is called a peak. Mountains generally occur in a chain or line called a range. The Himalayas in Asia, the Alps in Europe, the Rockies in North America, and the Andes in South America are some examples of mountain ranges. Mount Everest in the Himalayas is the world's highest peak. A small mountain is called a hill. Generally, hills have rounded tops. A lowland between hills or mountain is called a valley. Next is types of mountains. Depending on how they are formed, mountains may be of three main types: fold mountains, block mountains, and volcanic mountains. Fold mountains. Fold mountains are formed when a part of the earth's surface is pushed up to form wrinkles called folds. Fold mountains are formed mainly by the effects of folding on layers within the upper part of the earth crust. The parts that are curved downwards are called cyclines. These form valleys. Next is fold mountains. Fold mountains are formed when a part of the earth's surface is pushed up to form wrinkles called folds. Fold mountains are formed mainly by the effects of folding on layers within the upper part of the earth crust. The part of the wrinkles that are curved upwards are called anticlines. These form peaks. The parts that are curved downwards are called cyclines. These form valleys. Fold mountains are the most common type of mountains in the world. A fold mountain usually displays more than one type of fold. Anticlines and cyclines are the most common up and down folds that result compression. The Himalayas, the Alps, the Rockies, and the Andes are examples of fold mountains. Here you have an activity. Do it, then you will understand how fold mountains form. Place a towel on a table. Push the two ends of the towel towards the middle. Do you see how the towel wrinkles up? This is how fold mountains form when two plates of the earth crust push against each other. Next is types of a fold mountains. Fold mountains are divided into two types: young fold mountains and old fold mountains. What are the difference between the young fold mountains and old fold mountains, young fold mountains. They are of recent origin. It doesn't mean few years back. It was formed thousands of years back. But comparing to old fold mountains, young fold mountains are young. They consist of parallel range. Example, the Himalayas, Alps, Rockies and Andes are the examples of young fold mountains. Old fold mountains, they have been formed long ago. These mountains have undergone erosion for millions of years. They are low in height with a gentle slope and rounded peaks. The Atlas Mountains and the Aravalli Hills of India are the examples of old fold mountains. We are moving to the next slide, that is block mountains. Block mountains are formed when two tectonic plates move away from each other, causing crack on the surface of the earth. The cracking of the earth crust is called faulting. The cracks or rips are called faults. When the land gets uplifted between two fault lines, then it is called block mountain, fault block mountain or host, and a sunken portion is called a rift valley or graben. Young block mountains and rift valley have steep sides. The valleys are gradually widened as their sides are worn back by wind, water or ice. Example, the Vosges and Black Forest mountains of Europe. Next slide is volcanic mountains. We are familiar with the concept of volcano. How it occurs? We know it right. These mountains are a result of volcanic activities. Volcanic mountains are formed when molten rock, magma deep within the earth erupts and piles up the surface. Magma is called lava when it breaks through the earth crust. Below the solid surface layer of the earth, there is a layer of hot molten rock. Material from this layer may come out through openings in the earth's surface. On reaching the earth's surface, it cools and hardens. Sometimes it piles up around the opening and gradually forms a mountain. Such a mountain is called a volcanic mountain. These mountains are cone-shaped with a steep or gentle slopes. Fujiyama in Japan and Mount Etna in Sicily are the examples of volcanoes. We have learned about fold mountains, block mountains and volcanic mountains. Now it is very important to see the importance of mountains. How these mountains help us? Let's see. Mountains are very important natural resources. They are useful to us in various ways. Now, let's see in detail. Importance of mountains. The glaciers in the mountains give rise to many perennial rivers. Perennial rivers means ever flowing rivers throughout the year. Even summer season, due to glaciers melt, there is water. Rainy season, due to rain, there is water. So here we can construct dams, and it is used for irrigation, and we can produce hydroelectricity. The river valleys and gentle slopes are used cultivation. Mountains provide minerals for industries and stones for construction. Mountains provide timber, firewood, fodder, medicinal herbs, etc. Mountains are famous for their scenic beauty and therefore tourist destinations. Mountain slopes covered with a dense forest are home to variety of wildlife. Various mountain sports like trekking, climbing, skiing, whitewater rafting are also very popular. Mountains act as a climatic barrier. Example, the Himalaya. The Himalaya protect us from bittering cold and wind like in the North Pole. It also obstructs monsoon wind which comes from the southern part. Here we can conclude this session. Next slide, you have some exercise. Do it in your copy. Answer the following questions. First one, name the major type of landforms. Second, what are mountains? Third, distinguish between young fold and old fold mountains. Fourth, why are mountains important to us? Fifth, how are fold mountains formed? Thank you.